HLA-B27 is a genetic marker found in our DNA. It can be associated with a chronic back pain known as ankylosing spondylitis. But not everyone with HLA-B27 develop ankylosing spondylitis. And the exact relationship is still unclear. Some people have positive HLA-B27 test, but still not develop AS. Some have negative HLA-B27 test but still develop AS. But there is a correlation between people who have AS and people with HLA-B27. The good thing is, if one is HLA-B27 positive, it can be found out with a simple blood test. This is your blood. After an ESR test, it can be divided into red blood cells and white blood cells. The tiny white granules on the surface of white blood cells are HLA-B27. An MRI can also help find the presence of HLA-B27. An X-ray can also help find the presence of HLA-B27. HLA-B27 does not tell the whole story, but it can provide valuable clue to the doctor. So if you have symptoms like chronic back pain lasting more than 3 months, pain that wakes you up in middle of the night, and prolonged stiffness in the morning. AS may also affect your rib cage. There are chances of rib pain. Problems with your feet can also develop with problems like plantar fasciitis and Achilles tendonitis. These are common with people suffering from ankylosing spondylitis. Around a quarter of people can develop uveitis. This is a red inflammation of the eye. Dactylitis is the swelling of the entire digit, finger or toe. Talk to a good doctor, like Dr. McCarr, who can help you out of the problem.